Everything's included except the water in the cordless drill.
He'd give that to you too if you buy enough of them, I promise.
We do have some software in the background that helps with placement. Jonathan's been talking a lot about making sure that we have the sensors in the right location. We do offer that as far as our package goes. That's free for you to go to the CropX website, take a look at that, and we'll walk you right out to the field with your cell phone where we think we should place it. We like to put them between the plants post-emergence. You simply just take your drill out there, go ahead and drill yourself a little pilot hole. And we like to put a little bit of water in that pilot hole as well to make sure that we have really good contact with the soil. And you can let that sit for a little bit.
One thing while Ben's getting ready here that's unique about our sensors is they're non-slurry. So you don't have to auger a hole, then take part of the dirt that you took out, mix it with water, get your mud base, milkshake base, and pour it back in. There's none of that. So our design is a simple drill bit in the ground, you drill it out, and the way our sensor's designed with the 3D technology, it slices into the side of the hole where there's no slurry, and it makes installation a lot easier.
And so we have a sensor on top of the auger, on the bottom of the auger, and on the side. We measure both capacitance, which is a volumetric water reading, and we also do temperature at both our 8 and 18 depths. So once you let the water settle a little bit, you can go ahead and just screw that into the soil. Again, pretty self-explanatory. And then you can just take your, or just a little key that sits on top of here to finish screwing it in. And basically, you'll just screw it down until it's flush with the soil. That'll give you your proper depth. Once you get that screwed in, you're basically done with the physical installation of it. There's a QR code scanner right here. That helps geo-reference the sensor just from your application, from your smartphone and the CropX app. Scan that in. It'll activate itself, turn itself on, and you'll be up and going from there.
Within 30 minutes, you'll be received data from your sensor.
And you can grab the information from a website, tablet, smartphone, or computer. Ryan's going to go through a little bit what you might be able to expect from that.
The geo-reference is huge, especially, you know, it gets harvest time and you got a corn, a milo, or a field full of milo or corn, and you don't want to have to go out there on your hands and knees and look for it. You just pull it up on your phone. It'll say you are 1,125 feet, and you start walking. You know, you are 500 feet. It'll tell you where to go and how close you are to it so you can go pick it up out of the field. Like I said before, we're all about simplicity. Our software is ours. We have our own software platform. We don't third party it. We make the sensors, we make the software. Our headquarters is in Tel Aviv, Israel. That's where the guys that do all the software stuff are. But our US sales team is based out of Denver, Colorado, and we're spread out across the nation. There's two things I feel like make our sensors different. You know, and if you're using another sensor, there's some great products out there. I will not discount anybody else. I applaud anybody that's interested in using moisture sensors and conserving water. But the ease of installation, you know, you saw it was less than 4 minutes. Ben went from start to finish and installed it. And then the price point on our sensors. As Ben said, we read volumetric water content and temperature. So you say, okay, I buy the sensor. How does it help me as a grower? There's two different fields of thought. Where I'm at, in my main region, is right outside Lubbock, Texas. We're deficit waters. We don't have big wells like they do in Ben's part of the world in Nebraska. You know, I've got some guys, on average, they've got four wells tied together to get 480 gallons. So it's very important to them that they use that water wisely. So I'll use one farmer, for example, a friend of mine named Josh. He has a sensor. He bought several. He puts one in before planting time. This year it's been exceptionally dry for us. We've not gotten much moisture this winter. With our limited water, we want to make sure that our soil profile is full before we plant. So we'll turn our pivots on to fill our profile up, because we don't want to plant and be behind. If we're behind that far, we can't catch up. So he may have 10 sensors for 10 different circles, but he'll put one in the ground just to see where we're at in the profile. Is it full? Is it not? He'll also leave it in because the temperature is very important. A lot of these new seeds coming out are very specific about when they want you to plant with soil temps, and it'll tell you exactly what the soil temp is, and you can put the seed in the ground at the right time for proper germination. So it helps a bunch. So he'll put that sensor in, look at his profile, then he'll pull that sensor out of the ground when it's time to plant. He'll plant his crop, the crop comes up, you make sure you got a good stand, you put this right in the row, okay? Even if you strip till, once you get a good stand up, you put it right in the row with your plant. Scan it in every 30 minutes, start sending you information. It doesn't ding your phone every 30 minutes. The only time it goes off is when you log in to look at it. You can set up some alerts where if you have a field that drops below a threshold that you design, it will send you a text if you choose to do that. Say, hey, you know, Mr. Freeman, you know, your Johnson farm needs attention or what have you. So you get the probe in the ground, it's working. The way my guys down there have really bought into this, because we don't have a lot of overwatering problems in our areas. But where it's really benefited them is on conserving water. They're not going to turn that pivot on unless they absolutely have to. With the cost of our sensors, if you can save one rotation, you know, if you're running five or six wells, one rotation, you're going to nearly pay for your sensor. You save two, I guarantee you're going to pay for it. And if, let's say we get a big rain, and we get a 2-inch rain event, the wind blows like crazy for 2 weeks, you start getting nervous because you got so much money in that field. You think, well, when do I need to turn back on? My neighbor turned on, when do I turn on? You can watch that sensor and know with confidence before your plant ever gets to a wilting point when to turn that on. And for every day you can keep that turned off, you're putting money in your pocket. Likewise, it lets you know, hey, we've had a lot of high winds, it's been pretty hot, we need to turn that pivot on. So it's just a management tool. It's not the save all, but it helps you manage your water effectively and stay in tune with your crop.
And just to tag on something, this is a cellular device. We transmit via AT&T and Verizon. I put one in the both in the ground. They both have good coverage in here. We send SMSs. It's a little lower frequency than a voice or a data package. Often that makes it fairly easy for us to get through the canopy. It is important that you can send a text message from your field because that is how we communicate with the cloud. So just keep that in mind.
And an SMS forward. Text is much easier to send than a regular text is.
Yeah, if anything, we found that we have a lot better coverage than what some of the carriers even advertise.
So if you've been around, you'll notice some differences. Our sensor doesn't have a stand. There's no T-post, there's no pole, there's no solar panel, there's no cords. Everything is housed right here inside that little mushroom head. Each head's got, like Ben said, a cell chip in it. That's how we transmit our data to the cloud. Each one's got five AA lithium batteries in it. The battery life is guaranteed for 2 years. We believe it'll last up to 4 years. The sensors that we put in, we have 200 and something sensors that went in 2015 in Kansas. Not any of them had to have a battery replaced yet. The light's not even on. It's got a little battery gauge up there, but the light hadn't come on. When they go out, you call Ben, me, your rep, your affiliate, and it's $25 for the new battery pack. And we'll ship it to you that day, and it comes to you.
And we do also have a money-back guarantee, 30 days to make sure that you get cellular coverage in your area. For some reason, you don't get coverage, we'll make sure that you're taken care of.
The actual life of the sensor is estimated. We haven't had it this long, but we estimate based on product design and the things that go into the sensor. It's actual components. We estimate 20 years to be the life on the sensor. You know, granted, you'll have to put batteries in throughout that time. But that's the simplicity of it. You can check it from anywhere. I've got guys that, you know, a bunch of guys from Texas have been at the Houston Stock Show this last week, and they got wheat going. They're able to pull up their app on their phone, and they call back home and talk to their hands or their family and say, hey, I need you to run turn the pivot on over here. Our sensor's showing us dry. So they can monitor that from wherever they're at, from the kids' baseball games, from what have you. Like I said, we do have our own software. It's hard to see on the TV from out here, but when we're done talking, if you want to come in the tent, we got three slides. Our sensor does show a projection. So when you pull up your graph, it'll show you right now where you're at on each sensor. Like if you had three sensors in a field, which most of the time we put one in a field. But it'll pull up your sensors and show you the graph right now. It'll also give you a 3-day projection. And when it changes from now to projection, your graph lines go from straight line to dotted. The dotted is the projection. So each sensor you put in the ground is going to sync with the three local weather stations, the closest weather stations to it, that are publicly provided and free. It'll average the data from those three weather stations, come up with a projected forecast for precipitation, for wind, for ET, and it will give you a projected graph on your software. So it will say, okay, Ben, if you don't change, here's where you are today with the projected weather for 3 days. If you don't change anything, this is where you're going to be. And if you got a sensor that's going to show in the red, it'll show in the red. So you can make your irrigation choice accordingly. So if I know, okay, 3 days from now I'm going to be in the red, but the weatherman's telling me we're going to have a 70% chance of rain this weekend, I'm not going to turn that pivot on. I'm going to wait and see if we get a rain and see if it comes back up. How are our fill and refill points set? That's a question everyone asks. Our full point is saturation. All right, that means that soil cannot hold any more water. If it did, it'd be on top of the ground and be running off down your turn row. Our refill point is set at 50%. My guys that I work most closely with in Texas can't handle the 50% refill point. If they get down to 50% plant available water, they can't catch back up. So the farmer can move that line up and down accordingly. If you got a well that pumps 1,300 gallons, you can handle that 50% refill. If you got a well that's pumping 500 gallons, you may want to up your refill point and say, okay, I want my grass to turn red when I'm at 70% plant available water. It's simple click of a mouse or your finger, you just slide that graph up or down to wherever you want to manage it. Someone said, okay, Ryan, what happens if I run over this with my tractor? Okay, that's a great question. If you run over that with your tractor, it's not a problem. Ben will sell you another one. I'll sell you another one. Just as quick as we can do it. I've actually had a guy run over it with a John Deere 8120, just with a tire, and it didn't hurt it. But the same guy plowed over one with the offset, and he got to buy another one. So, you know, it's like anything else. The cool parts is there's no stands, no wires. You don't have to worry about it hitting a spray boom going across the field. You don't have to worry about a rabbit or a field rat chewing through your wires. You put it in the ground and it's pretty much bulletproof down there. So
if you have any questions, we can also pull some of the data that we've had out here last week, but we'd be happy to go through that. But other than that, we just really thank you for being here and being attentive. So
you bet. Y'all have a great day, fellas.